Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's update is about the hot highway or the part of Iceland's highway number one that has been heating up due to geothermal activity. And I'm leaving a link to the full story, of course. But the fast version is that around 20 kilometers away from Reykjavík, we have this volcano called Hengill. And just by it, we have a high temperature area and a power plant. And it is not unusual that geothermal areas undergo some changes. So when I made my first video from there, 1.5 years ago, with a thermal drone, I was not sure if this would turn into anything. But now it seems as this is leading us somewhere. And to make this simple, there are two areas that have been warming up. And it's only a few hundred meters between them. And the highway kind of splits them up because it runs through them. And it is the upper area that was first detected. And the lower area, it wasn't discovered right away. And it might have been my thermal drone that detected it first. But the upper zone, it has been more active from the beginning. This got so bad for a while that a steam pipe was placed there to prevent the road damage. But what might have rescued it is how thick the road embankment is there. And this started here. This is where all the steam was coming up. But my 6 thermal scans, spanning 1.5 years, they show it quite clearly that this high temperature area is moving further south. And during my last scan, few days ago, the changes were quite drastic. In the upper area, where those black spots indicate even more heat and steam, so there are more active events there now, and even more powerful. And in addition, I found the heat signals further east than usual, but I could not find any events there, and this wasn't actually not the ideal day to go thermal scanning due to the wind. So I ran into some problems. But got enough to see that there are some major changes going on there. And as for the lower area, the drone struggled so much that I didn't go straight over it, but I will have to check that better. So most of the changes I detected now were at the upper area, the south side, and it is always very interesting to look at this through the thermal drone. And this area was in fact one of the first tasks that I got for it. So I've done 6 scans so far, but since I wasn't sure at the beginning if this area would be worth the time to scan it, I have to admit that some of my files, the first files especially, they could be better organized as for flight paths and perhaps filming angles as well. But it does, however, depend on how cold it is outside, how I can approach those areas for the best possible accuracy. This is not as easy as one might think, but I can always say that this was a good practice and I know that I can put together a fairly good thermal map from each tour from the videos. But since I shot this all in video mode, it's a bit more complicated than to compare images all shot from the same location. But I have already started to sort the older files to make this comparison simpler. Or if this will turn into something. And there is another thing I need to mention, or the steam explosion that occurred there recently. This might have been caused by just a little steam channel that collapsed from it, and this doesn't look like a significant event, although it's quite visual in a landscape. And a few years back I remember when a geothermal borehole in the Krýsuvík geothermal area blew up. And that was quite a sight. So when I look at this, it looks like a small event. And during this day, when I was filming there with the thermal drone and the other drone, I didn't see much steam overall. Way less than I've often seen, although it was quite cold. But the day after, when I drove by, on my way to the south coast, there was more steam there than I've ever seen before. But I had so strict filming schedule that day, that I didn't stop by, but I would like to film it. like it was steaming when I drove by. And what this is all about, I'm leaving that to the experts. It's not for me to say. I'm just documenting this. But I will try to push this video so I will get some reaction. But what I can say without a doubt is that the geothermal activity there is not only increasing, it is moving as well to the south. And this area has only one heat source and it is magma. And the magma chamber under Hengill is at perhaps 3 to 5 kilometers depth. It's not very deep. So is this about magma on the move or are the steam channels under there just undergoing some changes? That might be the main question. And if this continues, this could be a problem with the steam coming over the highway every now and then. It can generate spots of ice during winter that could turn into nasty surprise for tourists especially. So the time might come that we will move this road, but we will know more about that later. And my next thermal scan will be during my next trip to Reykjavík and it looks as it's going to be within a month. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.